Today, I'm going to tell you a story about a boy who came from my hometown of Kerala, India. His pet name is Kutten. Now, why did I choose Kutten? Because I couldn't choose an American name. But for other reasons, I will tell you his name. He had a friend named Babu. He went to the same school as Babu, a small, regular public school, nothing really special. Kutten's family was very poor. They couldn't buy him books, but he was still a very, very bright student. On his way to school one day, Kutten asked Babu, "Can I please see your house? Everyone says it's so big. It's so beautiful. I just want to see it." Babu said, "No, I can't show it to you. My parents will get very mad if they see a poor person like you come to my house." After school that day, luckily Babu's parents were out doing a few errands. So Babu was able to take his friend to his house. Kutten saw his house. He was amazed. It was big. It was beautiful. It was luxurious. It was nothing like how he has ever seen. But it wasn't the beauty, the size, or any of that that had amazed him. It was the dog on the front porch. More importantly, what the dog was eating. The dog was eating a feast, a bunch of stuff. Some of the stuff Kutten wouldn't get even on days like Diwali or Thanksgiving. Kutten thought, "Wow, if his dog is eating this, then they must have a very luxurious lifestyle." One day at school, a school inspector came along and asked Kutten and his friends what they wanted to be. The kids said they wanted to be athletes, actors, lawyers, doctors, many, many more. But Kutten wanted to be one thing, and that was Babu's dog. Why, you may ask? Because Kutten was amazed and he didn't know any better. Now this shocked everyone, and especially the teacher. The teacher just had to know why this was true. The teacher visited Kutten's home, asked his family. They said Kutten did not have enough money to buy books or to study. So the teacher bought him books. Kutten started studying heavily, all day, all night. Sometimes he would skip school just to study. This became a habit. In fact, he grew very, very smart. By the ninth grade, he became the top of his class. In 10th grade, he was a state-level rank holder. After graduating high school, he went to a community college in Ernakulam. He didn't have enough money to go to a full four-year college. But thanks to grants from the government, because they saw his great potential, he went to Delhi University, one of the greatest and prestigious universities among India's universities. Then he studied in London, a dream that not everyone could have, a dream that only the greatest of people could have. And then you see Kutten, who was raised in a lower class, studying with all these great, bright people. It was a dream for him, a dream that had come true. on his way back home after he graduated and finished studying in London, his vice chancellor gave Kutin a note about his great potential, and he told him to give him to the Prime Minister Nehru. And Kutin was blown away by this. He didn't have any words for this. He was speechless, and he felt so happy for himself. On his way back home, he filed an appointment with Prime Minister Nehru. Prime Minister Nehru saw the note. What the note said is that Kutin had such great potential. He cannot be just used to teach at a college. He was supposed to be used for the Indian government. Nehru was blown away. He tried looking and looking for places where Kutin could find a job in the government. Nehru could not find any. Kutin had to go all the way back to his hometown in Kerala for the time being. Kutin was very disappointed. And then one day, a few months later, Kutin receives a note. Kutin is so surprised and happy to find out the note was from Prime Minister Nehru's office. It had said Kutin had to come back to New Delhi and talk with the Prime Minister. When Kutin arrived, Prime Minister Nehru said he had to be the ambassador of Burma India at Burma. This was great for Kutin. This set a whole other standard for Kutin's life. Soon enough, Kutin did become the ambassador, but Nehru wanted him to come back. Nehru told him to run on his Congress party. Kutin ran. He did great. Soon enough, he became a member of parliament. Then he became a central minister. And he had climbed the ladder very high. And in his hometown, there was a picture frame of the little boy who wanted to be Babu's dog. And under the picture frame was a caption. It said, K.R. Narayanan, President of India. The kid that had wanted to be Babu's dog had now become the president of India. Thank you.